Good morning, children. I'm back with the second part of the lesson, The Best Christmas Present in the World. In the first part, you read about how the writer finds a letter from a secret drawer of the roll-top desk while he was repairing it. Now, what was written in the letter? Let's read it in the second part of the lesson. Here is what was written in the letter. Dearest Connie, I write to you in a much happier frame of mind because something wonderful has just happened that I must tell you about at once. We were all standing too in our trenches yesterday morning, Christmas morning. It was crisp and quiet all about, as beautiful a morning as I've ever seen, as cold and frosty as a Christmas morning should be. Children, we already know that the letter was written by a person named Jim. And now we come to know that it was addressed to Connie. We also come to know that he was a soldier and he had written this letter to Connie on the day after Christmas to tell her about something wonderful that had happened on the Christmas. हमने देखा कि यह पत्र जिम ने, जो कि एक सैनिक है, कोनी को लिखा। उसने लिखा कि क्रिसमस पर एक आश्चर्यजनक घटना घटी जिसके बारे में वह उसे बताना चाहता है। Now let's read out the second paragraph. I should like to be able to tell you that we began it, but the truth, I'm ashamed to say, is that Fritz began it. First, someone saw a white flag waving from the trenches opposite. Then they were calling out to us from across no man's land. Happy Christmas, Tommy. Happy Christmas. When we had got over the surprise, some of us shouted back, same to you, Fritz, same to you. I thought that would be that. We all did. But then suddenly one of them was up there in his grey great coat and waving a white flag. Don't shoot, lads. Someone shouted and no one did. Then there was another Fritz up on the parapet and another. Keep your heads down, I told the men. It's a trick, but it wasn't. From this, we come to know that Jim was a leader of the England army that was engaged in combat with the German army at the time the letter was written. Jim wrote that he saw someone waving a white flag from the enemy side and heard Christmas wishes. The English army too wished them a Merry Christmas. Initially, it seemed to them that it may be a trick to get them out of the trenches. But it wasn't. यहाँ हमें पता चलता है कि जिम अंग्रेजी सेना का नेता था जो कि जर्मन सेना के साथ युद्ध में तैनात था। वह लिखता है कि क्रिसमस की सुबह वह शत्रु की तरफ से किसी को एक सफेद झंडा लहराते हुए देखता है और साथ ही क्रिसमस की शुभकामनाएं सुनता है। फिर अंग्रेजी सेना के कुछ सैनिक भी जर्मन सैनिकों को शुभकामनाएं देते हैं। शुरू में जिम को लगता है कि शायद यह जर्मन सेना की कोई साजिश है, परंतु यह साजिश नहीं थी। Now the next paragraph. One of the Germans was waving a bottle above his head. It is Christmas Day, Tommy. We have schnapps. We have sausage. We meet you? Yes? By this time, there were dozens of them walking towards us across no man's land and not a rifle between them. Little Private Morris was the first up. Come on, boys. What are we waiting for? And then there was no stopping them. I was the officer. I should have stopped them there and then, I suppose. But the truth is that it never even occurred to me I should. All along their line and ours, I could see men walking slowly towards one another. Grey coats, khaki coats, meeting in the middle. And I was one of them. I was part of this. In the middle of the war, we were making peace. Now, Jip further wrote that soon German soldiers offered to meet the English soldiers. They also offered them food and drinks. And then they started walking towards the English side. They had no guns with them. Soon the British soldiers too started walking towards them. Being an officer, he could have stopped them, but he didn't. Rather, he became part of what was happening. Jim आगे लिखता है कि फिर जर्मन सैनिकों ने अंग्रेजी सैनिकों को फूड और ड्रिंक्स के लिए पूछा
और धीरे धीरे उनकी ओर बढ़ने लगे। उनके पास बंदूकें नहीं थी, फिर अंग्रेजी सैनिकों ने भी उनकी ओर बढ़ना शुरू कर दिया। जिम लिखता है कि वह सैनिकों को रोक सकता था, पर उसने ऐसा नहीं किया, बल्कि उनके साथ ही मिल गया।
Now let's read further. You cannot imagine, dearest Connie, my feelings as I looked into the eyes of the Fritz officer who approached me, hand outstretched. Hans Wolf, he said, gripping my hand warmly and holding it. I'm from Dusseldorf. I play cello in the orchestra. Happy Christmas, Captain Jim McPherson, I replied, and a happy Christmas to you too. I'm a school teacher from Dorset in the west of England. Ah, Dorset, he smiled. I know this place. I know it very well. We shared my rum ration and his excellent sausage. And we talked, Connie, how we talked. He spoke almost perfect English, but it turned out that he had never set foot in Dorset, never even been to England. In his letter, Jim further wrote about how he met an officer of the German army named Hans Wolf, and they started talking about their lives, about the work that they do, about the places they lived. Jim was amused to see that Hans Wolf spoke fluent English and also knew a lot about Dorset, although he had never been to England. जिम ने अपने पत्र में यह भी लिखा कि वह कैसे हैंस वुल्फ नाम के एक जर्मन ऑफिसर से मिला। उन्होंने अपने जीवन के बारे में एक दूसरे को बताया। जिम हैरान था कि हैंस वुल्फ कभी भी इंग्लैंड नहीं आया था, पर फिर भी वह बहुत अच्छी अंग्रेजी बोलता था और उसे उसके शहर डॉर्सेट के बारे में भी बहुत कुछ पता था। He had learned all he knew of England from school and from reading books in English. His favorite writer was Thomas Hardy. His favorite book, Far From the Madding Crowd. So out there in no man's land, we talked of Bathsheba and Gabriel Oak and Sergeant Troy and Dorset. He had a wife and one son, born just 6 months ago. As I looked about me, there were huddles of khaki and gray everywhere, all over no man's land, smoking, laughing, talking, drinking, eating. Hans Wolf and I shared what was left of your wonderful Christmas cake. Connie, he thought the marzipan was the best he had ever tasted. I agreed. We agreed about everything, and he was my enemy. There never was a Christmas party like it, Connie. Hans had learnt all about England from his school and from books. They talked about the famous fictional characters from his famous Thomas Hardy book, Far From the Madding Crowd. The soldiers of the two sides ate, drank, and made merry. Although they belonged to different countries, yet they agreed about everything. It was the best Christmas party. Hans ne England ke bare mein किताबों में पढ़ा था और अपने स्कूल में सीखा था। थॉमस हार्डी की किताब फार फ्रॉम द मैडिंग क्राउड के प्रमुख पात्रों के बारे में वह बातें करते हैं। वे दोनों हर बात में एक दूसरे से सहमत होते हैं। वे खाते पीते और मजे करते हैं। जिम लिखता है कि यह उसकी अब तक की सबसे बढ़िया क्रिसमस पार्टी थी। Then someone, I don't know who, brought out a football. Grey coats were dumped in piles to make goalposts, and the next thing we knew, it was Tommy against Fritz out in the middle of no man's land. Hans Wolf and I looked on and cheered, clapping our hands and stamping our feet to keep out the cold as much as anything. There was a moment when I noticed our breaths mingling in the air between us. He saw it too and smiled. Jim McPherson, he said after a while, I think this is how we should resolve this war. A football match. No one dies in a football match. No children are orphaned. No wives become widows. As they were talking, laughing and making merry, someone brought a football and soon the match started amidst cheers. They all were very happy. At that time, Hans suggested that they should resolve war that way. बिकॉज देयर वॉज नो लॉस ऑफ लाइफ इन मैचेस। जब वे पार्टी कर रहे थे तभी कोई एक फुटबॉल ले आया और मैच शुरू हो गया। सब खुश थे और हैंस ने कहा कि हमें युद्ध के फैसले भी ऐसे ही करने चाहिए, क्योंकि इस तरह किसी की जान नहीं जाती, कोई अनाथ नहीं होता। I'd prefer cricket, I told him. Then we Tommies could be sure of winning, probably. We laughed at that and together we watched the game. Sad to say, Connie, Fritz won 2-1. But as Hans Wolf generously said, our goal was wider than theirs, so it wasn't quite fair. The time came, and all too soon, when the game was finished, the schnapps and the rum and the sausage had long since run out, and we knew it was all over. I wished Hans well and told him I hope he would see his family again soon, that the fighting would end and we could all go home. I think that is what every soldier wants on both sides. Hans Wolf said, "Take care, Jim McPherson. I shall never forget this moment, nor you." He saluted and walked away from me slowly, unwillingly, I felt. He turned to wave just once and then became one of the hundreds of grey-coated men drifting back towards their trenches. The German soldiers won the match and then the parting moment arrived. He wished Hans well and expressed hope that the war would end soon and they all would reunite with their families. Actually, it seemed to him that every soldier wanted this. जर्मन सैनिक मैच जीत गए और फिर विदा होने का समय आ गया। जिम ने हैंस को अलविदा कहा और ये आशा व्यक्त की कि युद्ध जल्दी ही समाप्त हो जाएगा और वे सब अपने परिवार के पास जा सकेंगे। उसे महसूस हुआ कि दोनों ओर के सिपाही यही चाहते थे।
So children, now you know what was written in the letter. Jim had written to Connie about how the soldiers of both the armies made peace during war. I hope you understood it well. I'll be back with the third part of the lesson soon. Till then, keep learning, keep watching.